Genau.
Oh ja.
Which does lead itself to weird bracket forms, because it's like, everyone gets one bye, which means that there's like a double round in losers, because of the way that people arrive there. Oh wait, Falco going with the Falco here.
Oh, by the way, Shot is getting shit on.
Oh no. I mean,
he's playing DDD.
Yeah, okay, I was about to say. But I think he played, the last time he played Mini Bulim, I think there was some DDD and some Game Watch and looked pretty similar.
Damn.
But both were pretty tough. Yeah, here it is. It was last week. Is this last week? May 21st. Yeah, that was last week.
Yeah.
There was a really weird interaction with Ivysaur's upbeat.
Oh yeah, I think I remember.
So we asked Mini Bully about afterwards, that's why I was able to check the chat and see how old it was. Alright, so he goes for the Falco instead of, I think he said Falco and Zelda in his name on challenge.
Oh. You wanna know some interesting facts about the Link matchup I learned?
From Falco's perspective, you mean?
No.
In general?
Like, in general, yeah.
Oh, yeah, sure, like, I agree with it.
I was playing Mahi.
Yeah.
And we were talking about matchups. Oof. And we talked a lot about the Link matchup. And he basically told me what you wanna do. Link is pretty bad out of shield. Like, he literally has zero options out of shield, they're all too slow.
Okay.
And what you want to do, it really doesn't matter which character you play, but the faster your character, the better. And in this matchup, you just have to... Oh god.
What the fuck?
Kind of disrespectful. You have to constantly just be in the guy's face. You just have to rush him down. Make him go into shield and punish his out of shield options, which are pretty bad.
That... makes sense, the way you say it, yeah?
He said that Link is like one of the few matchups where it's not about playing smart and neutral, but just playing fast.
Well, that's really bad for me.
Like, as soon as you give Link the space to like throw out boomerangs and stuff, then you're in a bad spot.
Yeah, that makes sense. Link's obviously a lot more happy when he can use the projectiles effectively. Bolts behind him, but still gets clipped by the upbeat. And well, then that makes Falco sound like a pretty good option.
And at the beginning, he was doing exactly that. He was just in his face, but now he's playing a little bit more defensive, I guess, because he's behind. But he was actually doing better in the beginning.
I mean, he was doing better until he lost the stock. You mean?
Yeah. Like. But, like, see like this, just... Now he gives him a break, he can throw out the boomerang and he wins neutral.
Well,
but before that...
fair, I don't think he gave him the break on purpose.
Yeah, of course he didn't. But, like, the moment he dropped the pressure, he lost neutral.
Alright. Oh, yeah, that just showed how slow his out-of-shield options are, right? Falco just up-tilted, I think it was the grab. But whatever it was, he just interrupted it with a hitbox.
You really can't do anything.
Can't do anything. What about Nair? Isn't Nair decently quick? I mean, obviously Nair out of shield is never going to be super fast, but...
I think it's still bad. Like, you can just react to it.
Yeah, I could... Yeah, like... Falco up tilt beating Nair out of shield wouldn't surprise me now that I think about it.
Oh no, he air dodged.
Alright. Ooh, the wall behind. Bold move. Also, I mean... Yeah, the more I think about it, the more sense it makes to me. Because, like, all of Link's smash attacks are pretty slow. And, like, not only the smash attacks, basically all of his moves.
Yeah.
So, if you can force him to use actual moves instead of projectiles to force you off of him, then you're already in a really good position, because He's going to be in a lot of end lag.
Oh yeah, Lois! Oh my god, the backup option.
Holy shit, that was... massive. He missed it, but then everything was alright.
So what you can do, if you want to pressure Link, because all of his out of shield options are slow, you can just do an aerial on shield and grab afterwards. Because the grab is gonna beat all his out of shield options.
Okay, but because I mean that obviously loses to spot dodge or roll.
Not really, because if you hit the shield, then he's still I don't think he can spot dodge immediately. But even if he does spot dodge, then you're still you can still react to whatever comes afterwards. But like, there's no out of shield option that would punish you for doing aerial on shield. I think that's what we talked about. So as Marth, for example, what you want to do, you just want to short hop fair on shield, and then just grab.
Okay.
If he tries to shield grab you, it's too slow. If he
that's obviously too slow. But I mean, like, still, if he spot dodges a grab, he's in a frame advantage, right? There's no way that's bad for him.
Yeah, but then again, after the spot dodge, he has the same problem. Because like he's also in a frame advantage when you do aerial on shield.
Yeah, that's true.
But he's just too slow to do anything out of it.
I guess it's... Yeah, I mean, I guess the grab just gives you a free 50-50.
Yeah.
Because the... if you win the 50-50, you get the grab, which is really good. And if you lose the 50-50, the situation basically doesn't change.
Yeah.
Huh?
Oh, that was...
that was awkward. I think he meant to do the... yeah, bomb protocol, right?
I don't understand why Fout keeps doing, like, a random up B when Lois is respawning. I think he did it every time. And
it's cool,
I
guess.
It always puts him in a bad spot.
Oh, Falco, the recovery is so bad. I feel bad for guys sometimes. Might be AFK for 1 second.
Sure.
Oh, right, what did I miss?
Like, the exact same thing we talked about. Fout was all up in his face and was shitting on him, and then he dashed back. Lois threw out the boomerang, did a Dacus, dark, and then it was even again. So at this point, I think at this point, Fout kinda should realize, and I think he does, that like just doing constant shine pressure on shield is the way to win here.
Oh, that was a really bad up here. Not quite fast enough to punish the down smash. But oh yeah, yeah, now he's in his face.
And he did a random up B again. Almost killed him.
Oh my god. F tilt into boomerang was kind of scary. Okay, nice up smash. Doesn't really do anything.
So what he did is, he jumped on his shield with, I think, down air, and Lois tried to shield grab, and
then
I think Fout... yeah, he shined him. So yeah. Like, it just doesn't work.
Same mix up as landing with an aerial and going for grab, basically.
Yeah. I think shield grabbing is pretty bad with almost every character, but with Link, it's definitely one of the worst out of shield options.
Yeah, I mean, the faster the shield grab is, the better it
is. I think Link's grab should only be used for hard reads and
deck chasing.
Yeah. Never for shield grabbing or doing neutral.
I mean, you can hard read neutral, but
nah.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
Oh, up we go! Those up bees, man.
Wow. Someone didn't get punished for it.
Oh no, he waited. Never mind.
Okay. Ah, he had that. Could have actually just up beat there when he was on the platform. Alright, up bees here. big lead for Fouch.
Oh no, he bombs himself. Oh, the boomer on Dacus works all the time.
It is pretty good. Oh? No, actually nothing, huh?
I really want Fouch to win this match. Okay.
So we can game 3?
Yeah, no, because I think if he would have lost this match, he would have DQ'd himself.
Fair enough. Yeah, we definitely saw Fouch adapting to exactly the thing that...
Isn't Delfinos illegal? Yeah.
You and Mayhew were talking about.
So Loas, Fouch still has one ban, right?
Yeah. I think he's thinking about it because, you know, he was...
Well, he banned Wario.
Oh wait, that's only one ban. He has two bans.
He does? Oh yeah, he does.
Okay, yeah, there we go.
I kind of disagree with this bans.
Small stages.
I think, yeah, he should ban big stages. What the fuck? Oh no, Loas lost. Loas lost. Yeah.
Oh yeah, we're smart. then these change bans make a lot of sense. Not change.
Oh no, wait. Actually, they don't. Loas lost, so Fouch is banning. So Fouch should ban two big stages, but he instead banned three small stages. And then Loas goes to a small stage.
Oh my god, you're right.
Did I ever tell you that I hate how everyone shits completely on the rule set? Oh my god, that's what you get, Loas. Holy fuck.
Oh, what do you mean? How people shit on the rule set?
So Fouch bans three stages.
Oh, did he ban three stages?
Yeah.
Maybe he banned the stage that Loas won on previously. Because
I think he did.
Doing the Dave stupid rule.
And then Fouch banned the wrong stages, in my opinion.
Yeah!
And then Loas took him to the only small stage that is left.
Yeah, I think Loas just got baited by the five head. That is...
Oh yeah!
You know, Fouch baited him into going for a small stage by making him think that he didn't want to go to a small stage. Damn, the boomerang's really nice for these edgeguard situations.
Yeah.
But
good sweet spot.
He didn't get the follow up afterwards, unfortunately.
Oh, that's a stock.
Yeah?
Oh, nice laser.
We take those.
So yeah, Fouch did the 500 IQ play.
Yeah, that has to be it. And well, yeah.
Oh my god.
I mean, I understand that Link like wants small stages in some matchups, but like
actually,
I don't think Falco is the one you want.
Actually, to. I think the stage pick is purely based on Lua's personal
comfort,
on stages.
Yeah.
He always goes to Fountain.
That could be it.
Like I noticed that like the last few tournaments he always counterpicks the Fountain.
He does really like Fountain and up smashing through the platform and stuff like that, which is pretty universal. So you know, Link certainly has some synergies with this stage, but
he's stuck.
Falco just dies. You know,
dude, he's just getting shit on. Like, Fouch was just in his face the whole time and he couldn't do shit. But for some reason, Fouch kind of stops being in his face after he reaches like 100%.
Yeah, and then he starts going to the platform and then he gets poked by Noah's sharking with up airs.
Oh no! What is this?
Oh. He's alive!
Thank god. That would have been super upsetting for everyone, in my opinion.
For you?
Oh no!
For me? For the
for
commentators?
Everyone.
For everyone?
Yeah.
Oh my god, this up!
Oh no!
But it sends
him
to the white side, not to the left side, so he's
Loas missed everything!
I like the grab there actually, because you know it was an attack chase situation, but he was slightly too slow.
Up here again? Oh no, he's stuck on the platform.
Oh! That's actually really nice. He pushed him off from the platform and then killed him with the second hit. There was a. I saw a video. I think it was about Melee, but I think it applies here as well. About how the push-off state...
Oh, that's a PM video.
Oh, that was the game with Arkion.
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah, and how you can abuse that. And I'm not sure if that was like on purpose or if he was just fishing for a shield poke or a shield drop, but...
My favorite part is that I didn't know that you can act frame 1 if you get pushed off a ledge if you're facing the right direction.
Yeah. Which way was it if you're facing in
the direction of the ledge?
Yeah. And if you face out, then you... then you're fucked.
That's it?
Yep. Wow.
Honestly, I thought Luas is gonna win.
Honestly, same.
Oh, wait.
So, 4-1-1.
Oh, I think we watch Edge versus Fout, right?
Yeah, I was about to say, I just want to continue the Fout going through the bracket. Because I want to see Edge play against them next. That seems interesting.
Do. Already sent the code. Join. Fuck. No.
Your name is awful.
What's up?
What's up?
So you guys, fill me in. What's going on?
Alright, so in the current tournament, we watched two sets. We watched Shot beat Hairy Beast. And we watched Fout NL beating Loas. Now we're continuing watching Fout, who is going to be playing against Edge next in winner semis. Man. Other winner semis is Mini Bole Widder, which is as seeded, so no upsets on that side of the bracket.